Welcome, children. Take out your history book. The Delhi Sultanate. Today's topic is the Tughlaq dynasty. 4 years after Alauddin's death, this dynasty was replaced by another dynasty. It was Ghazi Malik, another general in revolt who put to an end to the rule of Khaljis. He ascended the throne in 1320 and took the title of Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. In 1325, he died when a victory pavilion built for a public reception in his honor collapsed. Now, after Alauddin's death, his dynasty, it was replaced by another dynasty. And who replaced it? That was Ghazi Malik. He was Alauddin's general. He revolted and put the end of the rule of Khaljis. After that, he himself ascended the throne in 1320 and took the title of Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. In 1325, he died when a victory pavilion built for a public reception in his honor collapsed. Now, Muhammad Tughlaq. Muhammad Tughlaq was a man of considerable ability and the only sultan to have received good education. He was a person with innovative ideas, which, however, led him to ruin. Muhammad Tughlaq, who was he? He was a very man of ability and the only sultan who was too educated. And he was a man who had innovative ideas. However, all these ideas led him to ruin. That means he was a man who was a farsighted man, but all his ideas ended in failure. Now, taxation in Dob. He wanted to raise the revenues by 5 to 10% by increasing the land taxes and a few other taxes. Now, Muhammad Tughlaq, what he wanted to do? He wanted to raise the taxes by, he wanted to raise the revenue. How? That is by increasing the taxes from increasing the land taxes from 5 to 10% and a few other taxes. In 1306, he increased the taxation in the Doab region. Now, in 1326, what he did? He increased the taxes in the Doab region, which lies between the Ganga and Yamuna river. Unfortunately, occurred a severe famine because of the failure of rain. Now, unfortunately, what happened during this time? What happened? Severe famine occurred and there was failure of crops. People offered resistance, but the sultan officer continued to release taxes mercilessly. Now, people, they wanted some resistance, but this sultan officer, they were taking taxes mercilessly. The cultivators were therefore forced to abandon them. And for this reason, the cultivator, they were forced to abandon their land. The sultan tried to help the cultivators by giving them loans to buy seeds, bullocks, etc. Now, sultan, when he heard that, he tried to help the cultivators by giving them loans to buy seeds, bullocks, etc. Arrangements were made for the digging of wells for irrigation. He also made arrangement to dig wells for irrigation purposes. But still the scheme failed. The grant of loans came late since the people had nothing to eat. As the grant of loans came very late, and now what happened? The people, they had nothing to eat. They utilized the loans to meet their basic needs. And what they did? People who were very poor, they took the loan and to meet their basic needs. As a result, even usual revenue could not be released from Delhi. As a result, what happened? Even they could not take the usual revenue also they could not take from the Doab region. Transfer of capital. In 1327, he decided to transfer his capital from Delhi to Devagiri with a view to have the capital situated in the middle of the kingdom. Now, 1327, what happened? Muhammad bin Tughlaq, he decided that he would shift his capital from Delhi to Devagiri with a view to have the capital, he wanted his capital should be situated in the middle of the kingdom. Moreover, Delhi was continuously threatened by Mongol raid. Moreover, Delhi was continuously attacked by the Mongols. The sultan wanted the capital town to be safer distance from the invader. Now, sultan, what he wanted? That his capital town, it would be at a very safe distance, which would be away from the invader. The sultan ordered people to shift to Devagiri. Now, sultan, what he gave order? He got order that his people would shift to Devagiri. He was bent upon taking all the inhabitants of Delhi to the new capital. Now, he was bent that he had taken the vote that he would take away all the people of Delhi to his new capital. No one liked forced move. Now, none of the people, they liked to move. They like to shift his capital, shift their places. In fact, Daulatabad was more than 1,500 kilometers from Delhi. In fact, Daulatabad, it was in south and it was 1,500 kilometers away from Delhi. People suffered greatly from fatigue. Now, people, they suffered greatly from fatigue, hardships and even mental torture. The scheme was a complete failure. Now, scheme also ended in failure. As a result, the Sultan was convinced of the failure of the scheme. He ordered the people to return to home in Delhi. Now, when Sultan heard of the total failure of the scheme, he ordered his people to return back to Delhi. Now, token currency. In 1329, the Sultan introduced token currency by proclaiming that brass and copper coins could have the same use or function as that of gold and silver. In 1329, what happened? Sultan, what he introduced? He introduced token currency and he proclaimed that brass and copper coins will have the same function as that of gold and silver. This experiment also failed. Now, this experiment he had made, it also failed. Soon, the gold and silver coins disappeared from the market and false copper coins manufactured by people at their homes came into circulation. Now, soon what happened? This gold and silver coins, it got disappeared from the market. Instead, and copper coins made at home, they came into circulation. Trade and business came to a stand. Now, state and business, it also collapsed. All the failures affected the prestige of the Sovereign and led to widespread. Now, all these failures, what happened? It affected the prestige and Sovereign and led to widespread discontent. It fomented repeated rebellions in many parts of the kingdom. And it what happened? It fomented many repeated rebellions in many parts of the kingdom. Muhammad Tughlaq died while fighting rebellion in Sindh in the 1350s. Now, Mahatma Tughlaq, what happened? He died while he was fighting with his rebellion in Sindh in 1351. Now, take out your diary, write the Tughlaq dynasty, explain, homework, revise it. And with this, I'm ending my today's class. Goodbye.